Colorado. I'm doing a test. Hey, hey, is anybody?
How I need your love, how I need your love, it's tasting. When I taste tequila, baby, I still see you.
Hey! Woo, it's bright in here. Turn your eyes down, Tanya. What are you doing? Is anybody home? Friends are here. Hi, in the car of love and light. If this is going to make you nervous, then okay. Is this going to make anybody nervous? Okay. Now, those of y'all that are left, let's go. What we're doing is we're going down to the Kerr Market. I'm having a tad bit later dinner today because I started my, you know, I run an intermittent fasting schedule every day. Yes, I do. And I started my eating a little bit later today, so I'm good to go through about 6:30, so I need to get on with it. But I was looking, I was fixing to make my dressing, and I'm using raw whole hemp seed hearts because it's the day for omega-3. I have a system, you know what I mean? And I should have rethought this. I should at least got on the main road first. And anyway, so what I'm doing is I'm getting something to bulk up my dressing, and I want it to remain very creamy looking. I wanted to do something a little bit different so that you can enjoy a plethora of recipes as if I don't already have like 2,700 videos on this channel with so many recipes. But I really want to start making some kitchen recipe videos again together and bringing you into the new cottage, because I have an island there in the cottage of love and light. But anyway, I just wanted to remind you this. One great way to really lose some weight, well, that's not even really what I want to talk about, but while you're here, let's talk about it. So is this stretching out your fat, as if I've always talked about that, and bulking up your greens. If you really looked at the nutritional profile, even for example of a fruit smoothie versus a green smoothie, when you add in like a couple of cups of, say, dandelion greens or kale or spinach if you like something more mild, it's phenomenal. And you know, we wonder why. Well, you know, I'm not getting the things I need. Well, I don't know, are you living off raisins? You know, we gotta have some common sense in this thing. I mean, you need to take a more loving approach with yourself to learn and do all the things. Anyway, so when you are coming to dinner and you're really taking that, the fat, which I incorporate some raw plant fat in my day every day, but I don't need a lot to be everything I need and nothing I don't, you know. So anyway, with that in mind, I bulk up my dressing. Perhaps I make a sauce, which would be like a dressing, though less moisture. Or I make a soup, which even in the winter, I could blend up raw to touch. Think about this, a hot tub is around 104 degrees. Now that's warm on your hiney, right? Well, you can blend up your soup raw to touch as long as it's under 118 degrees. No nutrients had to be harmed. No, they didn't. So anyway, you know, do this in the winter, do this in, I've been a long time, you know, this will be coming up on my 13th year. So really there is at the end of the day, make an excuse or make it happen. Okay. It gets cold here in South Carolina. I don't live in the tropics. Also doing it on a budget, also doing it and still doing it. I have a whole video series called Overcoming Excuses that is really touches on a lot of those things. Common problems with people, or really it's just common things that come into their mind and they allow that to derail them, because the world's so noisy. You need a plan, you work your plan, you get results. You do it so long, it ain't even a plan anymore. It's just your regular scheduled program, you know? And then you can do other things. You can do all the things in the world. But how do y'all feel about this narrow screen too? I'm gonna look and see what you say, because I didn't turn it. I just wanna bring y'all along. So anyway, back to the dressing. When you're making the dressing, typically you can look at a lot of raw food recipes and you can see a recipe, it might have like, let's say, a cup and a half of cashews. I don't eat cashews, but, and then it might have a couple tablespoons of nut butter or little sesame seeds or nothing to bulk it up. It's gonna have some salt in there. It's gonna have maybe like some agave nectar. Let's get the triads of salt, fat, and sugar in there like the standard diet. Really high fat, salt, and sugar. That's what makes you want to come on back for some more. That's why it tastes good. But you can grow accustomed to these recipes because they are still decadent and satiating. So anyway, that kind of recipe, you could be looking at 1500, 1800 calories in that thing coming from fat. Like 90, 95 grams of fat in there. Okay, friends, a Big Mac has 33 grams of fat. No, it's not the same kind of fat, but still, you only need so much fat. On the other hand, could you get a little bit of weight loss if you just go all fat? Yeah, your body thinks you're in disease. It's shutting down, right? So anyway, that's not sustainable long term. You'll never convince me that eating all the foods that are proven to kill you. Let's eat all those, and let's don't eat any of the things that have life-saving properties. Any diet or lifestyle that you tell me you can't have any fruits or veggies and you really limit your greens, we got a problem, Houston. But anyway, back to the dressing. So you only need so much fat. So a lot of these recipes have so much fat, so much calories, that it's really hard to, you can eat that, but really, to get results, you can only eat a handful of that. And we have a thing in our stomach, in our tummy, called stretch receptors. It's part of the way we feel satiated and satisfied. So think about that. I want a large volume of food. So most of my dressing recipes do not have any more. They're typically 170 to 180 calories in there coming from fat. You're talking about a half of a dang blender full of dressing. Therefore, you can eat all the dressing, you can eat all the salad, you chop it fine so it's very decadent, it's easier to digest, and bam, you get all the results, right? I have a video called How Much Fat and What Types of Fat, where I'm talking about rotating your plant fat, omega-3 to omega-6 fatty acids, which I just talked about in my reset group. But anyway, so bulking up the dressing is what we're going to talk about. Let me see if I can see y'all's chat, live chat. I don't see. There you are. Hey, friends. Anyway, let me look at that in a second. So when we're bulking up the recipe, what I mean by that is you are adding in volume that doesn't add in calories. Furthermore, it's a flavor burst. Let's say you want to bulk up your recipe with like a cup of tomatoes. Maybe you use celery, which is great because that's got a salty flair too, which, of course, so do tomatoes, right? Also, you could bulk up with a peeled zucchini because you want to kind of take off that bitterness, you know. Also, you could bulk up with yellow squash. You could bulk up with mushrooms, the kind that you can eat raw. You can look up what types of mushrooms to eat safe raw. A lot of times people are like, well, you're eating mushrooms raw. I'm like, have you never been to a salad bar, babe? Like, that's, anyway, lots of things you could do like that. Red bell pepper, yellow bell pepper. I typically steer away from green bell peppers because they hurt my stomach. They're really up, they don't actually ripen up all the way, so it's like eating a non-ripe fruit to a lot of people. It can hurt your tummy, so I don't eat a lot of those. Occasionally I will, but anyway, the mini bell peppers, so many things. Carrots, baby, almost for carrots, okay? What about the carrots of many colors? What about, what else could we use to bulk? All the things. You could use banana peppers. You could use, anyway, bulking up the recipe. I have a video I did many years ago that stands tried and true today called Make an Awesome Raw Vegan Dressing Every Time. And what it's going to tell you in there in 15 little minutes is exactly how to do it. You can have your paper and your pencil. Get your paper and your pencil, and you could jot down your little chart. I also have that in my butterfly dressings recipe book that is on my TannyRaw.com. I have lots of recipe books, programs, helping, love. I'm trying to love you while you learn to love yourself. And if you don't have a dollar, then watch my YouTube videos. It's all there for you. Go to my Instagram where I have 8,000 posts, and every time, not every time, I would say 80% of the time that I show a recipe, show a picture, I show the recipe. Yes, I do. Anyway, so cashews aren't really raw. A lot of people eat those, but I don't. I also think they're expensive. They're also omega-6. I really like to not focus solely on, but I really like to hone in on the omega-3. Therefore, I am really getting some anti-inflammatory benefits, you know. Hey, friends. Every people are in the house. What are y'all doing? It's froze. Does anybody else have anything they want to talk about? Hey, Teresa. How are you, beautiful? Rachel in the house. What are you doing? Ah! Anyway, also, I'm going to be going on. I keep on saying this out loud so I will actually follow through with it. I am going to Ecuador. I know. On the 31st. Okay, I'm going. Now, whether I'm going to make it there or not, I have to change planes 3 times. And I... breathe. Anyway, so I'm going, and my friend is taking me. It's his job to do those things, and he wanted to take me. And anyway, so while I'm there, I'm going to be showing what I'm doing, and I'm going to be showing some clips. And I have no fear that I will be able to find things to eat, because it's such a freedom lifestyle for me that even if I'm out and about and there's nothing to eat, guess what? Does anybody know? Does anybody know the answer to that? If I'm out and about and there is nothing to eat, then it is not an emergency. Maritza in the house. Hello, beautiful. It is not an emergency. That is exactly right. It's not an emergency. I'll eat later. I'm not driven around by food addiction, toxic hunger. Okay? It's freedom. Am I promoting calorie restriction? No, I'm not. I'm saying I'll eat more later, you know? And it's beautiful. It's beautiful to know that my diet and lifestyle, for 17 and a half years have I been whole food, plant-based. Becoming really sick in my late 20s, almost to death. I have a video now, Healing with Raw Vegan. It's a playlist on my YouTube channel. And that's been a long time ago. I'm 47 and I wasn't even 30 and I was so sick. And that's been a long time. And the last 12 and a half years have I been low-fat Raw Vegan. Working my life, and my life's been working. And every year do I grow stronger? And do I even have more strength and conviction to the integrity, to the promises that I've made to myself? And will I ever abandon the lifestyle that healed me, saved me, and continues to regenerate me? You know, so much stronger every year. And even things that have become so much easier over the years, even eating around anybody, traveling, working my budget, tragedy coming and going, good things coming and going, all the things. I can handle all the things because I do all the things that create true health. And I talked to Dr. Karen Dina yesterday, and I'm going to be on the Raw Food Summit again this year. It is a free webinar, and I will be posting that on my media, how you can go and you sign up, and I'll give you the link. You go through my link, because then Dr. Karen and Rick, they know that, oh, Tanny's friends came over, and then they want me to speak again, and I love to say all the words because it's the truth, and I want to shout it in a way of, might I lovingly suggest you understand that health is your birthright. Anyway, and we talked about all the things, and it will start April 15th. And before then, I'll give you the links and stuff, and you can come over there and jump on it. What happens is you put your email, and the speakers, who it's pre-recorded like I was, come to your inbox each day and they say, hey, hey, I'm ready to chat today. And you click on okay, and then we chat. And there was all kinds of questions. We talked about all the things under the sun, Karen and I. And it's great. Tanny, what outfits are you planning for the trip? I'm not knowing. And I did get some new hiking boots, though. And I don't know what I'm going to be packing. I need to be cute, though, because it could be a love story. I'm not knowing yet. Don't get excited. And if it's not, then we will have loved every moment, right? And we will have no regrets. And we will always be glad that we chose a few moments of wonderful over a lifetime of nothing special. And me traveling is me coming out of my box. Right? Anyway, so thinking about that when you're bulking up your recipes. So I'm fixing to go in here. What I'm thinking about is, I kind of want red bell pepper, but then again, I've got raw hulled hemp seed hearts, so I might want something lightish, because I want to be able to plate that up beautifully, you know? Because really, it's self-love to plate up your food beautifully. My raw reset this time, I've never seen so many. I was thinking, friends, I need to up my game, because their posts are gorgeous. Hello, Barry. Barry from London, England. Hello, how are you? I bet you have an accent, and I bet you sound like Matthew Hussey. Do you know who that is? He's a dating and lifestyle coach. He's always giving me advice. I mean, I usually don't take it, but I look, that's like when I say, might I lovingly suggest, and you're like, yeah, and then you just put another Dorito in your mouth. See, I do that to Matthew, and he doesn't deserve that. Do y'all know who that is? Matthew Hussey. My husband's family runs a famous shop in Quito. I'm going there to Quito. And I'm going to, there's several like excursions we could do, and there's going to be singing toucans and the blue-footed boobies, and that's a bird. And then there's going to be a snorkeling, and there's going to be bikinis, there's going to be boat rides, and there's like a jungle we're going to be going in, and then there was like hiking around the volcano, and then there was hiking to Mount Tip Top somewhere. And though I'm worried, it's really high altitude, and I'm not used to that. So anyway, it's all the things. And now that I've said it out loud, I have said it everywhere, and now my daughter, there is no way I can't go. And plus, my son's like, you are letting your flakiness out of the box too early. If you back out of that, you really are. What are you saying? Hey, Roxanne, what are you doing? I am 47. Yes, I am. I am Granny Tanny. Right? My grandson is 5.5 years old. How did that happen? Thank you. You know what? What you don't see is how good I feel on the inside. Look back at my video 6 years ago. Regeneration is real, okay? And people want to say, oh, like, people like to say, like, I had an eye lift. I don't know how much that costs, but that's not in my spending plan, okay? I don't have peels, Botox, nothing like that. I use Swell Skin Cosmetics. And I've always baked in the sun and tanned and, you know, so it's like I have some weathering, and I used to have nodular acne, and I'm just telling you that it appears as though I'm growing younger over the years. I mean, that's what I see, because that's what I feel, you know. I have been on 100% raw food lifestyle, low fat, raw vegan for 12 and a half years, whole food plant based for 17 and a half. What does that tell you? For 5 years of that, was I tripping my way to figuring out how to heal myself? You know, so anyway, and I do have some things in my diet, like Frontier brand organic spices. Those are probably dried to a point that they're not raw spices, you know. And I also incorporate hot tea. And beyond that, I just don't need it. And that's not to say that in your life raw needs to be law, or I don't think of it like that. I just think, why would I want to do all the things to feel all the vibes? Right? I want to feel 100% my very best. And how can I do that how can I feel 100% alive if I'm not eating 100% alive? Maybe I could get away with 70%, but why do I want to be 70% of myself? I don't, you know? Anyway, I love y'all. I just want to say, hey, I wanted to see if YouTube Live, how this would come out. And then I wanted to just say live in love, you know? And if you didn't see my video I put up yesterday, where a lot of people are wanting to say, hey, Tanny Raw, are you still raw food? Tanny Raw, are you still vegan? Tanny Raw. And for a while I was like, why is everybody? And then I realized, okay, and I have a video where I'm talking about concepts, and I'm talking about ideas, and I'm talking about truths in my life, not talking about people. I'm just talking about love yourself more so you can love others right where they are, you know? Wanna hear if we have any music? Classic right there. Y'all wanna sing? Or shall we dance? You got your hair ready? Yeah! Thanks for riding along with Tanny Raw. See you later, alligators. Bye.